The boxers have been given their instructions. The seconds are out. The crowd is ready for another edition of Shoulder Roll Virtual Boxing with your presenter, the boxing historian, Greg Rashid.
I want to say 20 cups to everyone out there, which means hello and hi. This is Greg Rashid with another edition of the Shoulder Roll Virtual Boxing Podcast. I will be your presenter today, as I always am, but I may have a guest sometimes, so being the presenter on the show, we shall see. But anyway, we have fun here, and if you're new to the program, I guess I'm in Bangkok, Thailand, and you may hear some construction in the background. They're building it looks like a lake and a new condo right beside our condo. So it's going to be noisy. But people have told me over the years, when I've done other shows in Bangkok, they like the ambiance. So they like hearing those noises and here in Bangkok. Because a lot of folks, they never get to Thailand. But I have a lot of fans who are here in Thailand and listen to the show. But again, this is the Shoulder Roll Virtual Boxing Podcast, where we do what if fights. What if Muhammad Ali fought Joe Louis, which we had on here? What if Mike Tyson fought Muhammad Ali? That's the type of stuff we do on here. And what we use as our main vehicle as far as producing these fights is Title Bout Boxing 2 PC game. And it's a computer game, and I just put the fighters in there at your suggestion. Because a lot of these fights, the majority of fights are based on what you, as listeners, want to hear. And I'm so happy I got so many folks out there who want to promote fights. If you want to become an official promoter of the program, go to my Patreon site, Nourished by History. Also, go to my site, Buy Me a Coffee, and you can be a promoter. So we can keep the lights on, keep everything going here, get some new equipment, you know, so we can have a better microphone and all that. I had a great mic, but it died. It's been around me for, 8 years or so, but it finally died. I'm working on getting a new one, but you can be the ones that can promote this program by becoming a promoter, either on going to Nourished by History on Patreon or going to Buy Me a Coffee. Really appreciate that. Doesn't cost that much. It'd be worth it. And a lot of people love these programs, so I'm just so happy to be doing them. But yeah, you can do that. You can do that. But just so happy to do this. And these are fantasy fights and all that. But we also talk about real fights, and we have real fighters on here. As last week, if you listen to the program, we had the one and only Tavera Williamson, former heavyweight contender in the 2000s, great fighter, knockout out artist known as Top Touches Fleet. If you missed that program, just go look for it on my YouTube channel, Nourished by History. You can also go to the Sports History Network and find it there. It's also on Facebook. It's a little bit everywhere, but yeah, check it out. Great interview. DeVero gives a lot of insight into boxing as far as the ins and outs that a lot of you may not know. But today we're going to have a good time as we always do. And we're going to have right now, we're going to have two fighters featuring in the featherweight division. Danny Lutered Lopez versus Prince Naseem Hamed. And that's going to be a barn burner, I'm sure of that. And I don't know the result. You know, once I put this in the computer, we'll find out what's going on. And we'll have Shoulder Old Steve being the commentator. But before I do that, I want to give right now, we got a sponsor of the program that I like to, one of our sponsors of this program. So let's hear this right now on Shoulder Roll Virtual Boxing Podcast.
When you note the low prices of Clipper Craft clothes, you're apt to be puzzled. How do they do it, you'll say? Well, the solution's no mystery at all once you know the facts. What makes them great values is the Clipper Craft plan, concentrating the buying power of 924 leading stores across the nation. Yes, remember that you buy these famous clothes at your local, favorite local store, where you're treated as a person, not just as another number on a sales check. These days, practically everything you buy costs more, but not so with Clippercraft. You can select your fall Clippercraft suit at only $35 and $40, with a few special numbers at $43.75. Clippercraft topcoats and overcoats, too, are only $30 to $40. Sport jackets, but $24. Selling expensive clothes at inexpensive prices at the nation's finest independent stores is the great big idea behind the Clippercraft plan. That's why men who know insist on Clippercraft clothes. So be sure to visit the Clippercraft store in your city.
The leading stores in the metropolitan area that bring you Clippercraft clothes are Saks 34th, Broadway at 34th Street, Manhattan, Abraham & Strauss, Brooklyn, the Boulevard Men's Shop, Kresge, Newark, Newark, New Jersey, and the B&B Clothes Shop, 16408 Jamaica Avenue, Jamaica. These great, courteous, and friendly stores are proud to add their names to that of Clippercraft in the label of your suit, topcoat, sports jacket, and overcoat.
I'm sure you'll run out there now and get that Clippercraft, bro. But anyway, hope you enjoyed that little commercial. There's a little thing we do on here on the Shoulder Roll Versatile Boxing Podcast. But we're going to get to the fight right now. And we got Shoulder Roll Steve. He's going to commentate on this fight. And what we're talking about is featherweight division. Danny Lutered Lopez versus Prince Naseem Hamed. And I want to thank promoter Gary Blackman for suggesting this. Thank you so much, Gary. So let's get to the fight now on the Shoulder Roll Virtual Boxing Podcast. I'm your presenter, Greg Rashid.
This evening's 10-round bout in the featherweight division pits Danny Little Red Lopez versus Prince Naseem Hamed. The fight is being held at Wembley Stadium in England. 90,000 fans are here at the stadium to cheer on hometown hero Prince Hamed. The crowd has been singing drinking songs for 2 hours nonstop during the preliminary bouts. Now they're getting louder as the main event approaches. The referee will be Robert Byrd. Judges are Dynamite Jackson, John Plachek, Alf Sprung. Little Red Lopez enters the ring in his traditional Native American headdress, representing the Uintah and Ouray Indian Reservation in Fort Duchesne, Utah. Now here comes the prince. He is standing on the ring apron, waving to the crowd as they roar for him to do his thing. He waits for 5 minutes to milk in the crowd's cheers, then does his thing, which is doing a somersault into the ring. He points at his chin and points at Lopez, telling him he can't hurt him. Lopez motions towards Naseem to fight and stop showboating. After the ref gives the instructions, Naseem blows a kiss at Lopez. The bell has sounded for round one. The crowd is already on its feet. Danny Lopez comes out and misses with a right cross. Naseem Hamed lands a two-point combination. Hamed is moving in and out. Hamed lands a three-point left cross. Lopez is fainting, then misses a left jab. Hamed lands a two-point left hook. Lopez traps Hamed in the neutral corner. Lopez lands a four-point cross. Hamed shakes his head, telling Lopez he was not hurt by it. Hamed is dancing to Lopez's right with his hands at this hip, daring Lopez to hit him. That was a mistake on the prince's part as Lopez lands a solid right uppercut for 6 points. Hamed's legs were like jelly after that shot. Naseem grabs Lopez in a clinch. Hamed is bobbing and weaving when they break. Lopez is trying to find an opening. Hamed is fainting. Lopez lands a two-point left jab. The fighters are in ring center. Lopez misses with a right cross. Hamed counters with a partially blocked right jab for 1 point. Hamed is trying to find an opening with his probing left jab that is missing the target. Lopez is fainting. Lopez lands a two-point left uppercut. The fighters are in ring center. Lopez is trying to find an opening. Just before the bell sounds to end round one, Lopez lands a two-point left cross. The points scored in round one. Danny Lopez had 16 points. Naseem Hamed had 8 points. Lopez showed he is not intimidated by the hostile crowd by taking the fight to Hamed. Hamed appeared surprised at Lopez's power. Hamed's corner is telling him to take it to this guy. Stop playing. The bell sounds for round two. Hamed comes out and lands a leaping straight right for 5 points that buckled Lopez's knees. Hamed has cut off the ring and pinned Lopez on the far ropes. Lopez bounces off the ropes and moves to ring center. Hamed clinches and smiles to the crowd. Lopez is trying to find an opening as he steps away from the clinch. Hamed is dancing in and out. Lopez misses with a left hook. Hamed is bobbing and weaving. Lopez is trying to find an opening. Hamed is moving in and out. Lopez catches him with a four-point right cross. Hamed continues to dance in and out with his hands down to his sides. Lopez is fainting. Hamed goes flat-footed and lands a combo that rocks Lopez's head back for 5 points. The prince has amazing hand speed. The partisan crowd is loving every punch Hamed throws. Lopez misses with right uppercut. Hamed lands a two-point combination. Lopez misses with a left uppercut, then scores a two-point right cross. Hamed clinches. Hamed comes out of the clinch and throws a two-point combo. The bell sounds, ending round two. The points scored in round two. Danny Lopez had 4 points. Naseem Hamed scored 16 points. The instructions from the corner worked as Hamed picked up the pace in the second and showed off his flashy speed and power. Hamed is standing on the top rope, singing along with the crowd. The ref is urging him to fight as the bell rings for round three. The fighters are in ring center. Hamed is hopping around the ring, trying to find an opening. Lopez is stalking him. Hamed clinches. Lopez comes out of the break and hits Hamed with a low blow in frustration for his antics. The ref gives Lopez a warning. He also gives Hamed a stern warning for clowning. Hamed laughs and has pinned Danny Lopez on the near ropes. Lopez misses with a left cross. Hamed snaps his head back to avoid the punch. Lopez is fainting. Hamed is moving in and out. Lopez is fainting. Hamed clinches. As the ref breaks the fighters, Hamed turns to the crowd and sings along with them. Hamed quickly turns to Lopez and lands a two-point right cross to the gut. The fighters are in ring center. Hamed is moving in and out. Lopez is trying to find an opening. Hamed lands a three-point combination. Lopez lands a combination for 5 points that stunned Hamed, who immediately clinches. Lopez breaks out of the clinch and lands a two-point left cross. The bell sounds to end round three. The points scored in round three. Danny Lopez with 7 points. Naseem Hamed had 5 points. Hamed spent that round clowning, which led to him being hit with some solid shots. The crowd, though, loves his performance. Round four begins. Hamed runs right at Lopez and misses with a wild left cross. Lopez shakes his head. He cannot believe Hamed would throw a punch like that in a professional match. Hamed is moving about the ring, trying to establish position. The fighters are in ring center. Hamed feints a left and lands a solid right cross for 5 points. Lopez is hurt. He falls back into the ropes. Naseem Hamed scores 5 points. Danny Lopez is hurt. Hamed misses with a right hook. Lopez escapes the ropes and moves to ring center. Lopez lands a three-point right hook. Hamed ducks down and lands a three-point left uppercut. The fighters are in ring center. Lopez lands a four-point left jab. Danny Lopez scores 4 points. That was a clean shot. Hamed counters with a three-point left jab. Lopez misses with a combination. Lopez is fainting. Lopez lands a right uppercut for 4 points that snaps Hamed's head back. Lopez lands a partially blocked left jab for 1 point just before the bell sounds to end round four. The points scored in round four. Danny Lopez had 12 points scored. Naseem Hamed with 11 points. If Hamed stopped fighting with his hands by his side, he would be unhittable. That's how good he is when he is not clowning. A serious Hamed is a dangerous Hamed. Round five begins. Naseem Hamed is fainting and hopping back and forth on one leg. Is this boxing or a clown show? Hamed lands a solid right uppercut as he strings from one leg for 5 points. Lopez's legs buckled. Lopez clinches. Hamed wrestles Lopez and pushes him down. The ref gives Hamed a stern warning. The fighters move to ring center. Hamed is bobbing and weaving. Lopez misses with a right cross. Hamed is dancing in and out. Hamed lands a left hook for 4 points to the stomach that appeared low from my vantage point. Hamed is cautioned by Robert Byrd to keep his punches above the waist. The crowd is booing the ref. A paper cup is thrown into the ring, causing a break in the action. Hamed picks up the cup and acts like he is drinking from it. His fans are roaring their approval. The action begins again with Hamed landing a two-point combination. The fighters are in ring center. Hamed is pointing to his chin, daring Lopez to hit him. Hamed is moving in and out as Lopez tries to cut off the ring. The fighters are in ring center. Lopez lands a combination for 4 points. Hamed does a shimmy and acts like he was hurt, then laughs to the crowd. Hamed lands a partially blocked left jab for 1 point. Lopez misses with a left uppercut. Hamed counters with a 3-point left cross and then a 3-point right cross to the stomach. Hamed came in the last seconds of round 5 as the bell rings. The points scored in round 5. Danny Lopez had 4 points. Naseem Hamed with 18 points. A dominant round for the prince. The crowd is loving it. The bell sounds for round 6. At ring center, Hamed lands a 2-point combination. Lopez clinches. Hamed wrestles him into the far corner. Hamed lands a 3-point right hook. Lopez is bobbing and weaving, trying to get out of the corner. Hamed misses with a right uppercut. Lopez counters with a combination for 4 points as he battles out of the corner. Lopez lands a 2-point left cross as he pins Hamed into the ropes. Hamed's cornerman is telling him to get off the ropes. The second his corner stops pleading, Hamed lands a 3-point left hook at the bell to end round 6. The points scored in round 6. Danny Lopez had 6 points. Naseem Hamed scored 8 points.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Round 7 begins with Hamed racing straight at Lopez, then putting on the brakes to laugh. Lopez is shaking his head in disgust. Hamed is fainting, doing a shimmy dance. Lopez is moving in and out. Hamed is bobbing and weaving. Lopez plants his foot and lands a left cross. Lopez scores 5 points. Hamed was stunned by that punch, and his right glove almost touched the canvas. From my vantage point, his hand did touch the mat, and that is a knockdown. Lopez's corner is screaming at Robert Byrd to call that a knockdown. Lopez misses with a combination. Hamed is fainting and hopping on one leg again. The crowd is laughing at his antics. Lopez is moving in and out. Hamed lands a 2-point combination, followed by a 2-point right cross to the ribcage. Lopez misses with a combination. Hamed does a series of deep knee bends at ring center. He leaps into Lopez with a left uppercut for 6 points. Lopez is down. The ref counts to 8 as Lopez struggles to his feet. He appears out on his feet. Hamed lands a 2-point left cross, a 3-point right hook to the stomach, and a 2-point left jab as the bell sounds ending round 7. Lopez staggers back to his corner. He's definitely hurt. What a punch from Hamed. It looked like something out of a Popeye cartoon. But it worked. The points scored in round 7. Danny Lopez had 5 points scored. Naseem Hamed, in a dominant performance, scored 17 points. Hamed is on the top rope again, singing with the crowd, before the bell sounds for round 8. Hamed does a somersault off the rope to meet Lopez at ring center. Lopez clinches. He is still stunned from the last round. Hamed misses with a right cross. Lopez clinches again. Hamed lands a 2-point right uppercut. Hamed lands a 2-point left hook. Lopez counters with a 2-point combination. Hamed throws a left uppercut that knocks Lopez flat on his back for 6 points. Is he going to get up from that? Lopez gets up at the count of 9. The ref whips off his gloves and asks if he wants to continue. Lopez nods, he is fine. Hamed lands a 3-point right cross, another 2-point right uppercut, and a 4-point left cross. Lopez grabs Hamed in a clinch. He has no defense for Hamed's speed. The fighters are in ring center. Lopez lands a 2-point left jab. Hamed lands a 3-point right cross as the bell sounds to end ring 8. Another dominant round for the prince. Points scored in the 8th round. Danny Lopez had 4 points. Naseem Hamed points totaled 25. I want to remind you that you, the listeners, can become promoters of future bouts. The promoter of this fight is Gary Blackman. Next week's fight will be promoted by Bob Poet. Now on to round 9. The fighters are in ring center. Lopez is bobbing and weaving. He appears to have recovered from last round's beating. I spoke too soon as Hamed lands a 2-point combination. Lopez is moving about the ring, trying to corner the elusive Hamed. Hamed is skipping around the ring, laughing. The fighters are in ring center. Lopez clinches. Hamed breaks and rubs his right glove across Lopez's face, causing referee Bird to issue a stern warning to Hamed. Lopez's corner is screaming at the ref to deduct a point. Lopez misses with a combination. Hamed is winded, milling his right arm over his head, then lands a left cross for 6 points. Lopez hits the canvas with a thud. I don't know if he's getting up this time. Lopez pulls himself up by the ropes at the count of 7. He falls back into the ropes. Bird asks him if he is all right. Lopez nods his head. Out of the corner of my eye, I saw Lopez's corner start to throw a towel in the ring. But they changed their mind. Hamed lands a 3-point combination. Hamed lands a 4-point right uppercut that forces Lopez to clinch. Maybe the towel should be thrown in because Lopez looks out on his feet. Hamed lands a 3-point right jab and a 2-point left cross. Lopez is moving back with Hamed in hot pursuit. Hamed lands a 2-point combination as the bell sounds to end round 9. One more to go. Points scored in the 9th. Danny Lopez had 0 points. Naseem Hamed had 23 points. The ring doctor and the ref are in Lopez's corner. They may stop this fight. Lopez has taken a beating in the last 3 rounds. Lopez's manager signals he can continue, so the bell rings for round 10. If it was my fighter, I would have stopped it. The fighters meet at ring center, and Lopez lands a left hook for 5 points that knocks Hamed into the ropes. That one hurt the prince. Hamed bounces off the ropes and misses with a wild right uppercut. Hamed tries a left uppercut that lands for 2 points. Lopez misses with a left cross. Hamed counters with a 4-point right cross that snaps Lopez's head back. 1 minute to go in this fight. Hamed misses with a left cross. Lopez counters with a partially blocked 1-point right uppercut. The fighters are in ring center. Hamed lands a 3-point right hook, then a 3-point left hook. Lopez appears shaken by those shots. Lopez clinches. They break out of the clinch. Lopez looks like he is ready to lay down. Wow. With 2 seconds to go, Lopez lands a combination that knocks Hamed flat on his face for 6 points. There is no saving by the bell. Hamed staggers to his feet at the count of 8. His corner immediately rushes to help their fighter, as Hamed doesn't even know where his corner is. It is a shame this is only a 10-rounder because I doubt the prince would have been able to come out for the 11th. Hamed is in his corner, lying flat on his back as his cornermen fan him with towels. The ring doctor is calling for a stretcher. As far as points scored in the final round, both fighters had 12 points each. We have a decision. Dynamite Jackson scores the bout 97. 89 John Plachek scores the bout 96. 89 Alf Sprung scores the bout 95. 91 for the winner by unanimous decision. Naseem Hamed! The minute he heard he had won, Hamed sprang to his feet and did a cartwheel. So much for needing a stretcher. What a character! Wait a minute, what do I see? A golden throne carried by some fans is coming toward the ring. Hamed somersaults out of the ring and lands on the throne, but first, he's being carried through the stadium, soaking in the love from the fans. What an entertainer. Let's go back to the Bangkok for our presenter Greg Rashid after we hear from one of our sponsors.
Ladies and gentlemen, get ready for the ultimate knockout experience brought to you by Pillow Puncher Pro, the boxing sensation that's softer than a grandma's hug. Pillow Puncher Pro, where every hit feels like a hug, and every defeat is a chance for a power nap. Order now, and we'll throw in our exclusive Dreamy Corner kit for free. Pillow Puncher Pro. Because when life throws a punch, you throw a pillow. Order now and redefine the knockout experience.
Yeah, I know a lot of you out there are going to order that Pillow Puncher Pro. You know, one of our many sponsors we have on this show, on the show, the Road Virtual Boxing Podcast. I hope you enjoyed that fight. That was Naseem, you know, being Naseem, the prince being himself. You know, maybe we'll have to fight again for 15 rounds to see what happens. Because it looks like the prince was out in that 10th round. Lopez hit him with a shot, and he went down on his face. We think. You know, he may have been playing. You never know. Because Naseem is always just playing. But hope you enjoyed that fight. Hope you enjoyed that. And again, I want to thank Gary Blackman for suggesting that. But you too can be a promoter of a show. All you have to do is go to a Facebook, look for my name, Gregory, last name Rashid, R-A-S-H-E-E-D, or better yet, just go to the YouTube channel, Nourished by History, and just leave your comments there, or leave it on Sports History Network, leave your comments there. Wherever you find this show, wherever you're listening to it in the world, please do that, you know, because it's really appreciated. And I want to let you know, as Chodorong Steve said in the bout, next week's bout is going to be in the welterweight division. It's going to be Sugar Ray Robinson versus Sugar Ray Leonard. And I know some of you are saying, now wait a minute. You know, Robinson's like pound for pound, probably the greatest fighter ever. That's true, but you never know in a bout. And as I always say, you using this computer program, Title Bout Boxing 2, I could put these fights in 1,000 times. I could put Lopez and Hamed in 1,000 times. And it might be 50-50. Lopez might knock him out most of the fights and might be reversed. So with the Robinson-Leonard fight, we never know. But Bob Poet suggested that he's the promoter next week of the show. But you have your opportunity if you want to promote a fight. Just let me know. I'll be more than happy to put these fights on. Because that's what it's all about. It's for you. And before we go, you know, because we always talk about what's going on in boxing right now. And last week, I saw to begin the year, man, there was a great fight in Liverpool, England last week. It was a IBF Women's Welterweight Championship fight between the champions, Natasha Jonas and Michaela Mayer. And it was a 10-round just barn burner. And they gave it to Jonas, and Jonas is from Liverpool. So I think it was kind of it could have been a draw, actually. And Michaela actually came on at the end, the last four rounds. She was dominating that fight, but I can accept, you know, Jonas as the winner. And, you know, they didn't talk about a rematch. You know, Jonas is 39 now, I believe 39, and I don't know, she was saying in the interview at the end that, you know, she may have one more fight in her, but I don't know if she's going to fight Michaela again. I don't know if she wants to do that, but that was a great fight. And for some of you who are listening now, this, because I'm doing this on Saturday, the 27th, here in Bangkok, Thailand. But tonight in Phoenix, it's going to be an amazing fight. Hame Magia is going to fight John Ryder in the super middleweight division. And Magia, if he wins this fight, they're going to put him up against, so they got to put him against Canelo Alvarez. You got to do that. And Magia, I mean, Magia, if you don't know about Magia, he's 42-0. I mean, he does not play. And that would be, you know, he's a classic Mexican fighter. I mean, he didn't give ground or anything. To see him fight Canelo would be something. I hope that comes through. But first he has to go through John Ryder, who's also known as the Gorilla. And Ryder gave Canelo a hard fight last year. So hopefully, you know, Magia can win this fight. But it's going to be a hard one. But I think Magia will win it. And we'll see probably on Cinco de Mayo the fight. Maybe in the fall. Maybe in the fall. We'll see Canelo and Magia. Because that'll be a huge fight. You know, Hamia Magia, he is something. He's in that legacy. A great Mexican fighter. So I hope, you know, I hope the Canelo and Magia fight comes to pass. Because that will be great. But again, before I go here, I want to, I think we'll do another, we'll do a song on here. Now, I have to be careful with the songs. I find out I'm getting dinged by YouTube as far as some copyright issues. So I'm going back in time now. I want to do this song because I know some of you, I see those two promoters, Dougie Wuggy and John, they're going to get some hot dogs now. So let's do right now, Sam the Hot Dog Man by Lil Johnson on the Show the Roll Virtual Boxing Podcast. And that was Lil Johnson and a hot dog fan. The hot dog man. Hope you enjoyed that Root and Root show. I said my own show. I mean Shoulder Roll Virtual Boxing Podcast. I got so many shows on here. I mean, I've done so many shows in 20-some years now that sometimes no telling what I might say. I might give the announcement for a pledge drive on here. You never know. But anyway, hope you enjoyed that song. I know that Dougie Wuggie and Jim out there, the promoters, enjoyed that song. And hope you enjoyed the fight today. Hope you enjoyed that. But again, we're going to get out of here right now. And again, I want to remind you, go to the Patreon site. Look for Nourished by History. And become a promoter. I got to keep the lights on. I got to get a better mic. I got to get all this stuff to give you the best program possible. So please do that. Also go to Buy Me a Coffee. Look for Nourished by History. And also look for Show the Roll Boxing Podcast on there. And just give a little contribution, $1 a month, anything, what you can do. You'll be a promoter on here. You'll get a shout out. As I gave a shout out today to Sam Blackman. And I, give shout outs to anyone out there and Bob Poe. But just do that. Do that. Really appreciate it. Really appreciate it. I love doing the show. This is I've done many shows over the years on radio, cable television. And I got to say, honestly, I enjoyed all those shows, but I really am enjoying this thus far, and I see that a lot of listeners out there are enjoying it too. But to keep it going, I need your support. So please do that. Well, we're going to get out of here right now. I want to say, as I always say, go in love and go in peace. Help someone along the way, because we're all in this together. Do what you can in your community, in your condo area, in your farm area, apartment, wherever you are in this world. Help someone, especially a young person or senior. Or both, actually. But, you know, do what you can. Do what you can help folks. And remember, every time you get up, every morning, hug yourself and say, I love myself. Look in that mirror and say, I love myself. If you're sight impaired, get up, hug yourself, and say you love yourself. Because if you don't love yourself, you can't help anyone. You can't help yourself. You can't do anything. But bring positive vibrations to wherever you are. It helps everyone when you can, because we're in this together. So again, this is Greg Rashid. Go in love and go in peace. We'll see you next time on the Shoulder Roll Virtual Boxing Podcast. Take care.
Thanks for tuning in. See you next time.